Hello everyone, and welcome back to another video, the tea on NPD and relationships. So of course, before we get started, I want to invite you to hit that subscribe button, hit that follow button, and come follow me as we discover our destinies. To my new subscribers and new followers, welcome. To my tribe and family at large, hey, listen, welcome back. Thank you for visiting my media resource and finding value in something that I have to say. I appreciate your time. And if you like the content that I am bringing to you, why don't we let the YouTube community know by simply hitting that like button? It gives our tribe and our family right here on the T the greatest opportunity to grow. So, of course, before we get started, I want to let you know I am a certified professional life coach. So if you are looking for life coaching services, please email me at the teonnpd@gmail.com. That is the teonnpd@gmail.com. I want to direct your attention really quickly to the merchandise. So we have a store on our channel. We have the Tea on NPD merchandise there by Teespring. Get your Tea on NPD merchandise right here on the channel, y'all. And of course, last but not least, our community tab has some great information. Make sure you check that out at your leisure. The community tab is right there. Make sure your alert button is on so you get all notifications for videos when they are uploaded, and any information that I'm communicating to our tribe right here, make sure that your bell icon, the one at the top, is lit with the two little things on the side. I forget what those are, but anyway, make sure you have your alerts on so we can keep you, of course, up to date with everything that's going on here on the channel. So, y'all, let's talk about this topic, these narcissists and that invalidation. Yes, let's talk about it, birds. Okay, so listen, this is one of the most, I think, one of the most deviant things, okay? Not the most, but one of the most deviant things that a narcissist likes to do. Now, I wanted to cover this because I've seen it more than one time in the comments, and I've definitely seen it in emails on my other social media platforms. So I felt like I needed to actually talk about this invalidation thing. Now, a lot of times, you don't know what's happening at the time when you are with the narcissist, especially in the love bomb stage. Narcissists actually start to invalidate during the love bomb stage. Now, typically, you won't know that they're actually invalidating you because they're covering it up with, you know, a lot of the love bomb too. But if you think back really close, you will see that there were certain things within, okay, within that love bomb stage, different things that you may have discussed with the narcissist, different things you may have said about hobbies or interests that you had, or accomplishments that you had made, you know, that the narcissist just didn't really have much conversation for, okay? Now, it starts in the love bomb stage. Now, you're not really paying attention to it because you're so caught up in everything else that the narcissist is talking about. Now, the other things that the narcissist is talking about generally in the love bomb stage is all the things, watch this, that are going to ultimately benefit the narcissist. Yes. Okay, all of the things that all of the different qualities that you have that are going to make the narcissist feel some type of way, give them that good, warm and fuzzy feeling, give them that supply that they want, that delicious fuel that they want so badly from you. Yeah, these are the things, if you really go back, okay, to the love bomb stage, the things that they were really talking to you about and love bombing you about were things dealing with the emotional side. I'm telling all the tea tonight. Okay. The emotional side of who you were. Never really anything dealing with the logical side of you. Because narcissists don't really care about the logical side of you. Because see, they're not logical people. They're very stupid. And I say that, I said it and I mean it, selectively stupid. Okay. That's what they are. Narcissists don't ever want to deal with the logical side of you. Narcissists want to deal with the emotional side of you. This is why they start out with the love bomb. Okay. This is why they continue in that emotional way all the way through the situation and the relationship, because this is the only thing that they can captivate. Because remember, your soul, okay, which houses your will, your mind, and your intellect, which also houses your emotion, is what they are after. Okay, they want to captivate the mind. They want to take control of your control center. And this is the way that they do it, is in an emotional way. So everything that they are validating you on and love bombing you with has to do with a feeling that you are going to give them. Okay, they're never really talking about the things that you like to do, what you like to accomplish. Now, they will talk about it if they want to mirror you. But if you in the beginning, everything that they are validating you on is all of the qualities that they are going to use to extract fuel from you. Now, here's the thing. When the invalidation really honestly starts, it starts in the love bomb, but back when you hit that devalue stage, come on, when you hit that devalue stage, the invalidation is going to come, okay? It's going to come a little bit more regular. You're going to notice that everything that you say, okay, everything, if you say that you want to go eat seafood, the narcissist wants a hamburger. Okay. Now you may not see that as invalidation, but, and also it's a part of being disagreeable. That's a part of the invalidation, because narcissists love to be disagreeable, because they want to see you sweat. Okay. They want to draw that emotional reaction out of you. But ultimately, what invalidation is actually used for is to tear down your self-esteem. Okay, it is to make you feel lower than the bowels of hell. Okay, this is what, just like whatever you're suggesting, whatever you're interested in, it is not even worth a conversation. It's not even worth them having a second thought of. And this is what they want to make you think and believe. If you like a particular song, the narcissist hates that song. If you want a particular thing, or you want this type of dress, pants, or shoes, the narcissist hates it. And all of these things are used as tools of invalidation. Okay? You tell him or her, you want to go to this specific college or this specific university to study this, then they have a lot to say about it. Now, they don't have the degree the first. They don't have the first degree, the first college degree. Okay, or the first trade or certification for anything, but they are going to absolutely invalidate what you're doing, because there is a process, okay, to the progress of this invalidation. It is used to destroy the essence of a person. It is used to make you feel like you are nothing, and whatever you want or desire, it does not even warrant a conversation or a second thought, baby. And let me tell you, it works like a charm, because a lot of times when we come out of these narcissistic relationships, we have to find who we are again. Because in that whole circus with that whole bird clown, okay, we are simply trying to struggle to survive. And what you find yourself doing is constantly trying to figure out what is it that the narcissist loves And I'm telling you, all of this is by design. You lose yourself, okay? And everything that you want and love and desire in life that validates you, that gives you that you need to keep going. You put all of that down because of all of the invalidation that you are getting from the narcissist. Narcissists don't like anything you're doing. They don't like what you're singing. They don't like what you're listening to. You can't cook anything correctly. You can't put the clothes. You can't fold anything correctly. Oh, the car is not washed properly. Oh, the kids don't look like they need to. I mean, just any and everything they can do to destroy every decision that you make. So you find yourself going on this wheel like a hamster, trying to figure out what is it that you can do to restore some balance and normalcy back in the relationship. But there's no restoring the balance and normalcy because it's dysfunctional out the gate. Okay? It is dysfunctional out the gate. So now you lose yourself in trying to figure out what else can you do to make this bird, a whole clown, happy. So that's how you lose yourself in this whole invalidation game. Now you running around trying to get this from the store because that's their favorite snack. Oh, you going over here to the department store because that's their favorite kind of cologne. Now you're driving 20 miles down the road because that's their favorite dinner. I mean, you are doing everything that you can to try and please this bird because they are on a whole rant of invalidating you and who you are. All you're trying to do is get back to the love bomb stage. But that's never coming back because that person is gone. Now the mask has slipped just about all the way off. Because at this point, when they start with that invalidation, and don't get me started with the triangulation, how they bring that in there, that's a whole nother video. But this is what they do. They do it to keep you trying to constantly please them, and you lose yourself in the process. You can't cook anything right. You can't, they even talk about the bedroom, talk about what you're not doing in the bedroom, but they're not doing anything either. I mean, you probably had a whole lot better, a whole lot more times than you did with the narcissist, okay? So that, I mean, nothing is off limits for them to devalue you. And see what they use in this whole invalidation game, okay? They are testing in this invalidation game is what can they get the biggest reaction out of you? What is it in this whole game is going to make you react the most? And that is the thing that they're going to compartmentalize. Okay, all of the little things that you react to, you give the biggest emotional reaction to, are the things that are going to be used against you in that triangulation, in that projection. All of these things, the narcissist is storing them up to use against you later. I'm telling y'all, it's the sickest thing you ever seen in your life. It is abuse from top to bottom. This is what they do. In that invalidation, they want to absolutely destroy your self-esteem, make you feel like you are nothing. And this is the reason that they do and say all of the things that they do during in this particular type of abuse when they are enacting this whole invalidation. I'm talking about you can't do anything right. I'm telling y'all. You can't say anything right. Why did you have to have a conversation like this when it should have been like that? I mean, right down to they want to tell you how you need to put your clothes on one pants leg at a time. No fool. Like I'm going to put them on two pants legs at a time. Most people put them on one pants leg at a time, but they have a problem with that. So these are the things that they like to do to invalidate you. If you find someone doing things like that, I mean, you mentioned your accomplishments and things that you have done, you pay very close attention to that. Moving forward, if someone always wants to deal with the emotional side of you, And they always want to dig into you and figure out what's going on with you, what makes you tick. Be very watchful of those kinds of people, because 9 times out of 10, all they're looking for is things that they can use. All you're doing is giving them a big stick to weaponize against you. Okay? See, a person that really cares about you, they're going to celebrate your good and they're going to comfort you in your bad. Okay, a narcissist is going to always, in this invalidation, they are always going to be the opposite of what you want to do. That is the design. Okay, it's by design. That's the design of the game. It's like moving chess pieces, honey. Everything is strategic that a narcissist does. So that invalidation makes you lose yourself. And it has you running on a hamster wheel, trying to figure out what you can do to please this whole clown that's selectively stupid and cheating and running around behind your back. And the bird family is covering for him or her. It is all designed for you to ultimately lose who you are. When you see something like this, and when you think back on it, or if you ever come up on someone that is not willing to celebrate your accomplishments out of a logical perspective, and they always want to deal with the emotional side of you, you cut them off. You don't have time for that, because that right there is a signal that there is a deeper problem. And people like that are 9 times out of 10 highly toxic individuals. Highly toxic individuals. They want to destroy you, and they are looking for things to absolutely destroy your self-esteem. That is what invalidation is all about, to make you, to destroy your self-esteem and make you lose yourself in trying to please another person, a bird that's not even worth your time of day. So I had to cover that subject, y'all. I wanted to make sure that I gave it some justice and made sure that I got that out to this beautiful tribe, because I don't want you all to be fooled by what these birds do, because they start in validation in the love bomb stage, baby. They coming with it in the love bomb stage. It's very subtle. Be careful. Watch as well as pray. You know I love you all. So until the next video, you all be safe, be blessed, and highly favored. Don't forget to hit that like button. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And until the next video, you all be safe and be blessed. I'll see you all at the top. Love you. Ciao.